Okay, welcome back to the next part of arches. So we'll slowly go deep into the analysis of arches. Now here the objective of this video is to arrive at equations on how to find the ordinate of any point on this three-hinged parabolic arch. That's one equation. And the second equation, we will see how to write the equation for the normal thrust in the arch and how to write an equation for the radial shear in the arch. This normal thrust and radial shear, I will tell you with one more figure. First, let us find how to find this ordinate yd of a point D on this parabolic, three-hinged parabolic arch. Now, for that purpose, what I have done is, I have taken point A as the origin. So let this be x-axis and let this be y-axis. Let point D be at a distance of x from point A, that is the x-coordinate of point D, and the point D, let it be at a distance of yd from this x-axis, that is the yd coordinate, that is the y-coordinate of this point D. Now I can easily write the equation of yd using the equation of parabola. So the equation of yd will be equal to, means the value of yd, how to find it, it is 4 h x divided by l square. Let me explain you all these terms one by one. L minus x. Now this yd will actually give you the ordinate of this point D, where h is actually the central rise of this arch, which is this distance, that is distance from here up to point C. This is h. L is the total span of the arch, and x is the x coordinate of point D, which will be known to us. So using this equation, we can easily find the ordinate of this point D. Now how to find the slope of this point D? Let me draw one more figure here. Okay, now I have drawn two points here, two lines here. One is the horizontal line at point D and one is the vertical line at point D. I'm drawing a tangent at point D, and the angle made by that tangent line with respect to horizontal, I will name it as phi, and that is actually the slope of point D. Now to find the slope of point D, we have an equation, that is tan of phi is equal to 4h divided by L square into the bracket L minus 2x. So this first equation will actually give you the ordinate of point D on this arch, and the second equation will actually give you the slope of point D. Now I will tell you how to find out the normal thrust and radial shear with one more figure here. Okay, now this diagram, what I have done here is, I have taken this segment, that is from A to D. So this is actually point D. Okay, now what I have done here is, I have drawn two lines, that is this green color indicates the horizontal line at D, and this green, another green color indicates the vertical line at D. Now apart from that, I have also drawn two more lines which are in blue color. So this line is actually a normal line at point D, that is, which is normal to the plane at D, and this line is actually called the radial line, which is actually the perpendicular line to the axis of the arch, right? Now this is HA and VA reactions. So we'll have two more reactions at this point D, that is which will be actually HD. Let me call it as HA only. Okay, we'll assume that there are no any other forces. So this is HA and this is VA, and I've also told that this is the slope of line, slope of the tangent at point D, which is denoted by the term phi. Now this is actually the ordinate. This is the ordinate which is there of D, that is, this is yd, that is this distance from here to here, it is yd. Now how to find this normal thrust and radial shear? So the normal thrust is actually denoted by the term NT, so that is normal thrust ND is equal to, so that is, I have to resolve this HA and VA along this normal line, knowing this angle phi. So when I resolve this HA along this normal line, so that will be like this. That resolved component will be like this. Let me just correct that. So that resolved component will be like this. Okay, and the value of that will be HA cos phi. So to write here, HA cos phi, and when I resolve this VA along this normal line, it will be VA, but the phi is actually made with respect to horizontal axis. So this component, when I try to resolve this VA along this normal line, it will be VA sin phi. Okay, so HA cos phi plus VA sin phi. Now what we are doing here is, we are assuming that the forces which are towards the arch, we are taking it as positive, and the forces which are away from the arch, we are taking them as negative. So now this equation will give you the normal thrust at any point on the arch. Now regarding the radial shear, it is also same procedure as we have done. So the radial shear will be, radial shear I will denote it by RD, that is radial shear at D. Now I have to resolve this HA along this radial line. So when I resolve this HA along this radial line, it will be HA sin phi, and that will also be towards the arch. That will also be towards the arch. That's why I should write it as plus. So it should be HA sin phi. Now when I resolve this VA along this radial line, so that component will be actually like this. Okay, and it is away from the arch. It is away from the arch. So I should write it as minus VA. This angle I have to find, or I have to find this angle. So this angle I can easily find. So since this angle is 90 degree, so this angle will be equal to 90 minus phi. So I should write it as VA sine of 90 minus phi. So now these two equations will actually give you the normal thrust and radial shear at any point on the arch. So now we will use these three equations, that is the equation to find the ordinate at any point, the normal thrust at any point, and the radial shear at any point, and we'll solve few more examples in the next video. Thank you. Bye.